It's a new week, and that means new comic book day. But before I hit the shop, I always want to know what's on my radar and what I plan to pick up. So that's what I want to talk about today. But before I do that, go ahead and like, subscribe, comment, tell me what books you're excited for this week, and connect or follow if you're on those platforms. The first book I want to talk about this week is Big Girls number 5. I've really enjoyed Jason Howard's Big Girls. It seems kind of like a dumb concept, but I've really enjoyed the way that the action and adventure kind of like pulls you through the story. The mystery as you start to uncover Ember's story and some of the things that are going on there. The whole like shadow government thing I think is really interesting. And of course, the big girls remind me of kaiju, and they feel a lot like Evangelion-style kaiju monsters, not like your traditional kaiju. So that always gets my attention. And honestly, this is a book, every time I put it down, like, I'm still thinking. And I really like books that make me think about things from like a moral or ethical or even perspective standpoint. So ironically, I'm sure it sounds kind of crazy, but Big Girls to me has been an awesome read. I want to check out The Expanse number 1. I believe this is a licensed property based on an Amazon show. It's been recommended to me several times. I really need to watch it, but I'm too dumb to sit down and watch it, I guess. But it's really interesting stuff from what I hear. And so if they're going to do a comic, I can usually focus on comics a little better. So I figure that's a good way for me to jump into that universe and see if it is something I enjoy so I can go watch the series on Amazon Prime. Stargazer number 4. I am behind on by one issue, I believe, so I'll need to read that before I go pick this one up. But the first two books were incredible. I think Stargazer is a unique and very like modern tale. And so I think everybody should be reading it. No reason not to check out Stargazer. I really like it. It's like this weird, trippy brother-sister relationship with some like PTSD elements to it. You know, so it's really cool stuff. I really like it. You should definitely check out Stargazer. We Live number 3 is going to be out this week. I'm really excited about this book because I really like the first two. I think this was a lot of fun. It's almost like the dark and twisted version of something that Pixar would put out. You know, and it's like pulling on your heartstrings in all the right ways. The artwork is beautiful. It looks very much like an animated series or an animated movie. The characters are like really likable and they're, you know, you have to admire their innocence, but like there's this awful thing happening, you know? So it's got these weird elements where like, say like Finding Nemo, they kind of lean into like the more positive side of that and lighten it up with jokes, but We Live kind of leans into the truth and reality of that a little bit more. I will say the panel work is a little, I don't know, it's kind of choppy. It feels like there's big gaps between panels in a kind of weird way. So I could see how that could kind of turn you off. At the same time, because the panel pacing seems slightly weird, it almost leaves me unsettled. And that unsettled feeling, I think, contributes a lot to, like, the great, almost jump scares, to be honest. Like, everybody says you can't do jump scares in comics, but I feel like We Live 1 and 2. Like, the first issue had a moment where it was, like, almost hard to watch, you know? And then the second one had a legitimate jump scare. Like, I was reading, and I was surprised at what happened, and I, you know? So, We Live is really cool stuff. I think they're trying something different. And it's a little early to tell if it is or isn't working. But at the end of the day, the story is really good. The characters are really awesome. The colors are beautiful. I love the world that it's set in. And I really suggest everybody be reading We Live. We Only Find Them When They're Dead, number 4. Pretty excited for this one. This series is definitely like a slow roll. And the first issue really didn't give us much of anything, but it did kind of establish this world I wanted to explore. And then the second one did more expansion on that. And then the third one really started to get into the characters and give us some cool surprises. And so I feel like this whole series is just kind of like an onion. And we're just going layer by layer through the whole thing. And it's really cool the way it's unfolding. It reminds me of more like long form sequential storytelling, like Avatar, The Last Airbender, or something in that nature. So I don't think it's going to be a real quick payoff, but I'm in for the ride. I really like it. I could see how a lot of people would prefer to read this in trade, but I'm excited every month when it comes out, so I'm going to stay on that. The other two books I want to talk about are more than likely the books we're going to be talking about on Thursday night Powered Up Chat on Burke Family 54's channel. So Batman 105, we've been following this series. Honestly, I'm not that into it right now. Very little has happened. It feels like they're just kind of doing a thing because they have to do a thing, but it definitely feels like we, the audience, are begging for more information and they're just unwilling to give it, and that would progress things a lot and it would feel a lot better, but I just feel like we're not getting that much information. 104 was better than like 102 and 103, but there's still like a lot of room for improvement there, so I hope Batman keeps getting better, but I'm going to keep reading it as long as we're talking about it. So that should be a very popular pickup. I doubt I got to tell many people to pick it up. Pretty much everybody's reading Batman, I think. And then Power Rangers number 2. This book is going to be so cool. I really liked Power Rangers number 1. It was really cool because it felt real traditional, like, here comes Jason, Trini, and Zach, the Omega Rangers, and it feels like a real classic Power Rangers episode. And then, like, halfway through the book, it turns into a heist book. And it just felt, like, so genre-like that I really enjoyed it. I like heist book, or, like, heist stories and stuff, heist movies. So I'm sure part of that was, like, I really enjoyed that little, like, genre nod. But it was well done. It was really cool. The artwork is substantially better than what we were getting in the last couple series and all that. So I'm excited to continue reading Power Rangers. Mighty Morphin has been good, but it's not my absolute favorite of the two. If I had to pick better of the two, definitely Power Rangers so far. Of course, that's only one book in, but we'll see what happens. I do hope we get a little more genre work. Like, I really like the idea of Power Rangers being like this genre exploration of what Power Rangers could be in other genres. So, yeah, I'm really excited for that. I'm sure that one and Batman will be two of them that we're talking about on Thursday night Powered Up Chat with Burke Family 54 Comics. It will more than likely be Burke Family 54, Steve, Adrian, Panda Awesome 316, and Mark from Legion of Comics, and myself. So check us out. 8 o'clock Central Standard Time is our main operating time, and we'll see you there. So what are you picking up this week? What are you excited for? What is on your what's on your pull list? What's on your radar? Is there anything you're looking to just kind of check out and see if you like it and want it? Or is there some yellow lights in your categories? Let me know what books you're picking up, and until next time, keep flipping pages.